Coming to the absorption of food materials. What are the materials absorbed through the small intestine, through the walls of the small intestine, into the blood or lymph? Initially, drugs and liquid materials, especially water. Liquid materials, especially water and drugs, which are directly absorbed through the walls of the specific organs, especially stomach, and which are absorbed into the liver. Previously we discussed why the liver may be affected. Because of the absorption of the drugs directly into the liver, which damages the liver, it causes the liver cirrhosis. Liver cirrhosis. And again, absorption of the mostly takes place depends on three types of activities or transports. One is an active transport, and second is a passive transport, and third one is a facilitated transport. Facilitated transport. We know about that one, diffusion. Diffusion is nothing but high concentration to the low concentration. Means movement of materials like ions, which are moves from the high concentration to the low concentration. That is called simple diffusion. So presence of huge amount of that electrolytes such as Na+ along with the sum of glucose, galactose and amino acids, which are considered as monosaccharides. Actually, these are the forms of carbohydrates or nothing but starch. The glucose, galactose and some of the amino acids along with the electrolytes such as Na+, especially Na+, which are passes through the walls of the small intestine, or especially below the small intestine, which utilizes some energy. Then the transport is called active transport. So active is nothing but which utilizes the energy for this activity. So for this transport, which utilizes some energy, that transport is known as active transport. Whereas passive transport, which does not require energy for the transport, means Cl- ions, especially chloride ions, Cl- ions, which are passes along with the Na+, then which does not require the energy, that is called passive transport. So active transport, which is utilizes energy, does not require energy. Not requires the energy for this transport. So for this transport, which one means Cl-. And coming to the passing of substances depends on the concentration gradient. Initially we explained that one. Means more concentration, which moves from the low concentration. More concentration materials which moves to the low concentration levels. So passage of substances depends on the concentration gradient. And coming to the another one, the movement of glucose, there are amino acids and are coupled on the concentration gradient of Na+. Means once the Na+ transfers through the wall of the small intestine, for simultaneously glucose and amino acids also follow. So that is called co-transport. And however, fructose and amino acids, which are absorbed with the help of Na+ carrier ions, that is called facilitated diffusion or facilitated transport. And coming to the water, transport of water, which depends on the osmotic gradient. osmotic gradient or osmosis are nothing but reach a high concentration to the low concentration levels. Again, these are the some of the amino acids and carbohydrates and some of the electrolytes. Amino acids, carbohydrates are nothing but glucose, and some of the electrolytes like Na plus and Cl minus, which are transported through these three forms: active forms, passive forms, and facilitated forms. Okay, coming to the next talk, continuation. Coming to the next continuation of the topic, absorption of food, absorption of lipids. Lipids which are present in the form of globules are fat globules. The biofilms which emulsify the fat globules, the biofilms which forms the emulsified droplets, and in the presence of lipase enzymes. Which are converted into the free fatty acids are nothing but monoglycerides. The monoglycerides which are directly again connected with the bile salts, which are modified into the micelles, small droplets. Which are incorporated with H2O water. The micelles which are incorporated with the intestine, which are incorporated with the H2O. Then the micelles which are moved into the intestinal epithelial mucosal cells. Intestinal lumen, which enters into the intestinal mucosa layer. Intestinal mucosa cell layers. Then the micelles, which forms as a chylomicrons, which are covered by a protein coat. The chylomicrons, which are covered by a protein coat, fat globules, protein coat like fat globules, which are transported into the lymph or blood capillaries. By exocytosis. Once again, the fat globules which are not directly enters into the intestinal mucosa, which are not directly absorbed into the intestinal mucosa, means which are converted into a protein coat like structures, which are called chylomicrons. Chylomicrons means the fat globules are lipids which are modified into the chylomicrons, protein coat protein coated chylomicrons. Then only which enters into the mucosa layers, mucosa cell layer. Otherwise, the protein body, the fat bodies which are not absorbed through the wall of the intestine, means the fat globules which are modified into the chylomicrons via this process. This process takes place in the intestinal lumen, lumen of the intestine. So first one, fat globules with the help of bile salts converted into the emulsified droplets, emulsified fats, which are modified into the free fatty acids that are monoglycerides. The monoglycerides along with the bile salts which are modified into the micelles, small droplet like structures which are incorporated with the H2O. Then the micelles enters into the wall of the intestine, which are surrounded by a protein coat. Then only which are enters into the intestinal wall. The protein coated triglycerides are considered as chylomicrons, which are transported into the lymph capillaries or blood, especially lymph capillaries, by exocytosis. The chylomicrons which are transported into lymph or lymph capillaries by exocytosis. Then the lymph capillaries which are enters into the thoracic duct, the thoracic duct which leads into the left subclavian vein and on the respective side of right subclavian vein, left subclavian vein and right subclavian vein. Then only the chylomicrons which are broken down into the fatty acids or glycerols in the presence of lipoprotein lipase enzyme. Now the chylomicrons which are broken down into the fatty acids and glycerol by lipoprotein lipase in the endothelial walls of the layer. Then the fatty acids and glycerol which are diffused into the adipocytes, the glycerol and fatty acids which are diffused, the fatty acids and glycerol which are diffused into the adipocytes. Adipocytes is nothing but adipose tissue. The adipocytes are present in the liver. So the fatty acids and glycerol which are diffused into the adipocytes are especially adipose tissue, then stored in the form of neutral fat or tissue fat. Then which stored as tissue fat, which are stored as tissue fat. Now which is stored as tissue fat. So absorption of the absorption of the lipids takes place by this process from the intestinal lumen to the via into the blood via epithelial cell layer or nothing but intestinal mucosa. The emulsified globules or fats which are modified into the chylomicrons, these chylomicrons are broken down into fatty acids plus glycerol. The fatty acids and glycerol which are diffused in the erythrocytes, which are stored in the liver as natural fat or neutral fat or tissue fat. Again, then the thoracic vein that which opens into the left subclavian vein and nearer to the left jugular vein, then only enters into the bloodstream and which are transported through the blood. This is the absorption of food particles in the small intestine. First one is proteins and second one is glucose and third one is lipids. And coming to the absorption of large intestine, generally there is no digestion takes place in the digestion of the large intestine. Especially some of the drugs, water and some of the minerals which are absorbed in the large intestine only. Next up it is absorption in large intestine. Large intestine. No digestion takes place in the large intestine. Whereas some drugs and some minerals and water molecules are absorbed in the large intestine. In the large intestine. So whereas again, absorption of the vitamin B12, cyanocobalamin. When requirement of the absorption of the vitamin B12, again another enzyme secreted from our body, that is a casein's intrinsic factor, which absorbs the vitamin B12 with the help of some of the microorganisms which are present in our body, or the elementary canal part, which absorbs the vitamin B12. Even absorption does not take place, the vitamin B12 which does not take place, the absorption of the vitamin B12 does not take place in the body, which leads to the pernicious anemia. This topic we previously discussed at the particular gastric gland secretions. Then remaining after the absorption takes place in the large intestine also, remaining food material which is formed in the waste materials which are adjacent to the rectum and anal canal and anus from the body. Here absorption of the materials which takes place in the body cavity and stomach, some amount, not exactly large amounts, and mostly absorption takes place in the small intestine. Absorption mostly takes place in the small intestine. So the formation of food material is, we know the formation of the food material in the buccal cavity, the food material converted into the bolus. The food material that are converted into the bolus, whereas in the stomach, the food material converted into the chyme. Whereas in small intestine, the food material modified as chyme. So here we previously discussed the chylomicrons. Chylo means very minute particles. These are the modifications of food material from the complex molecules to the simplest molecules. another one. Assimilation. What is meant by assimilation? Okay, coming to the next topic is assimilation. After the absorption of these food materials, which are transported by the blood or lymph, especially the lymph, means the chylomicrons which are enters into the lacteals are which are transported by the blood, where the food particles are materials which become integral components of living protoplasm which are essential for the production of energy and growth and repair the tissues. The process is called assimilation, means the energy is utilized for the various types of activities like growth and repair the tissues. The energy which is transported by the blood and which are modified into the integral components in the living material, which is called protoplasm. The material is, major thing is protoplasm. The process is called assimilation. And the next one is defecation. Removal of the waste substances which are stored temporarily in the rectum and passes through the anal canal and passes out through the anus via anal canal. We previously discussed about that one, two types of sphincters, internal sphincter and external sphincter, which are controlled by the two types of the muscles, involuntary muscles and voluntary muscles. So removal of the waste materials through the anus, the process is called defecation. This is the major part of the digestion.